You complain more with the rest of it.
Like this year or like in general?
No. Well, we only got this year to compare.
One of the strengths of you, Moe, even when you're not in the game, your voice can always be heard even outside, even from the bench. Did you always have this, Moe? Did you always have this voice, or did you have to develop this over time?
Wow, that's a deep question, because I mean, I obviously, like Franz said, we're two very emotional guys. Mm-hmm. I give our parents credit for that. I will say, though, that energy can go both ways, right? Like, you can go frustrated, you can go in. I call it my own, or Coach Bean, I would always say I would go on Motron, my own little planet, and like leave the world for a couple seconds and do something crazy. And you can have a very positive impact. And it's been a challenge for me to my entire career to kind of channel that into the right direction. Mm-hmm. And however you express that, whether that is clapping, picking up people, or even letting your voice be heard, but then also shutting up at the right moment sometimes is very valuable as well. You complain more with the rest of it.
Like this year or like in general?
No. Well, we only got this year to compare.
I would think you're more known for complaining than
that's
I am.
Because I have more years on my belt.
That's what I'm saying?
that's unfair though. I will say I got better going from college to the NBA. In the NBA, I realized that you have less impact. Franz and I talk about it all the time. Like when we watch basketball, it's the worst job in the world because it's so difficult, because you can't win and you have to make decisions real time. So I have a lot of respect, obviously, but in the emotion of the game, and you get lost in that. So yeah, we are, again, very expressive, very emotional, but I would say we're both
working on it.
Yeah.
Now, I think for me, the bigger challenge is how do I get my mind off of the game? Whereas in college, I'm forced to because I'm in class half the day anyway. You kind of have to find other ways to occupy the mind with something else than basketball.
In college, I would work out sometimes at night, even though we had practice. Like, just because I loved it so much and I had this dream of going to the NBA and being drafted. And all of a sudden you get drafted and it's your job and it's your responsibility. And all of a sudden the love for it seems secondary, and it's on you to kind of get that back, you know? And to me, I struggle with that at first, because when you don't play and you don't have a great season your first year, and you struggle and you have situations, like Franz said, you travel a lot, that's work, you know? And then when you go to the gym, it feels like work. So getting back to getting lost and just playing basketball, regardless of your professional situation, is something that was extremely valuable to me now and holds me over water every day. Just the love for the game. And that definitely changes as soon as you get paid to do it.
Do you guys speak German on the court? Maybe to throw the opponents off sometimes, maybe call a play in German or something, like a backdoor cut or something?
If you say something in just the team lingo, the other team will know it too, what's about to happen. So when you say it in German, obviously, sometimes our own teammates don't even know. So that's been helpful for sure.
Now, since the season is almost over, what has been the best part for you?
Obviously, it's my first season too, so it was a lot coming into it, and I didn't really know how to handle stuff and what to expect. So for me, it's been a huge help for me for after games and on road trips and stuff like that, when there's really a lot of alone time, to have someone that you can talk to, sometimes about on the court stuff, but also just talk about some other stuff and get your mind off of the game for a little bit. I think that's been really helpful for me, and obviously my first time going through it.
I've always wanted to have that college feel again, where I have a roommate and kind of share a place to stay, and to be able to do that with your brother is really cool. And obviously I look at back in my time, I was like, how did I survive without that? You know, it's kind of cool now how it is, and yeah, I'm really enjoying it.